Welcome to the digital learning class of mathematics. As you all know, we are in chapter number 2, that is polynomial. And now we are using identities in polynomials. How we can use for factorization or for multiplication algebraic identities. So today I am going to tell you about how to factorize any polynomial by using algebraic identities. So first have a look over algebraic identities. First identity, a plus b whole square. You can write it a square plus 2ab plus b square. Even you can write this b square in starting and 2ab in last. A minus b whole square, that is a square minus 2ab plus b square. Next is a square minus b square. That become a plus b and a minus b. X plus a into x plus b. That is x square plus a plus b into x plus a into b. These four identities we are going to discuss and how we can use these identities in the questions. So have a look over question number 3, that is factorize the following using appropriate identity. First is 9x square plus 6xy plus y square. So I'm taking your first part, how to solve. Before starting how to solve, you must know comparison of identities. So let's see how to compare. You see what is the first term, 9x square, something is in square, 6xy, 2 term are in multiply, then y raised to power 2. All sign positive, so it is look like first identity, that is a square plus 2ab plus b square. So how I can convert this question in the form of this identity, that is very important. So first, you need to think how you can write this question again. It is given to you 9x square plus 6xy plus y raised to power 2. This is given in the question. So some tricks that you need to use here. You can directly first write by using a plus b whole square, that is a square plus 2ab plus b square. So what is my task here? First task is to find out what is the value of a, what is the value of b. So for that, you can think here, 9 is given to you, 9 you can write 3 into 3. So that means, I can write 3 is also 2 times, x is also 2 times, 3x raised to power 2, plus sign. Next, I need 2, but I have 6 here, second number. So it can be written as 2 into 3, so write it 2, then 3 of x of y plus last number is already in the square. So from here if you will compare, so but what is the value of a is this one, b this one, so you can say a is 3x and b is y. So by using this identity, this is okay. Now I can write it in the form of 3x plus y whole square. This is the answer of first part. How I did? First, write a question, try to split it, check it, it is look like which one? It is look like first. So now compare it, and after comparing, try to split the term as I did 9. 3 is 9. In between, this is 6. But I needed 2ab. So it can be written as 2 into 3 into x. So 2 into 3 into x into y. It becomes 2ab plus b square. Compare and you can write a answer. So have a look over second part. How to solve second? Second is 4y square minus 4y plus 1. So if you see, my dear student, this question properly, so it is look like second one. Square, then minus term, then plus term. So this is given to us. You can write it is as 4 is the first term. 4 you can write 2 into 2, that means 2 is 2 times, 2 into 2, 2 is 2 times, y is already given 2 times, so it becomes this one, minus 4, but I need here 2 into ab, so 2 into 2 of y plus 1 raised to power 2, 1 can be written as a 1 raised to power 2, it remain 1. So now by using a minus b whole square, it become a square minus 2ab plus b square. So how I can write? My task is to find out a and b. A value is here 2 by, b value is 1. So I can write 2 by minus 1 raised to power 2. So this is required, and even you can write it in the form of two terms. This one also upper one. 3x plus y into 3x plus y. This is the factorized form. Similarly here, you can write 2y minus 1 into 2y minus 1. Why I have written 2 times? Because power is 2 times. So I can write the same term 2 times. So this is the way to solve the questions. How to find out answer. So have a look over the third part. Third part we have here. This one. We have third part now. Third part is very easy. Third part is x square minus y square upon 100. This one. So you can see it is look like third identity. This one. A square minus b square. Directly you can write by use, and in denominator there is 100. So you can write it x square y square upon 10 raised to power 2. So it become 1 time x plus this one, and 1 time x minus which identity is used? By using a square minus b square, that is a plus b and a minus b, and here the value of a is x and value of b is y upon 10. In this way you can solve such questions. I hope it is clear to you how to solve such questions.